or virtually somebody could be, you know, not getting the oxygen that they need. And of course here, like I said, oxygen is just like a medicine. So if a person's not getting their heart medicine, what's going to happen? Their heart's going to be in trouble. Well, this person not getting their oxygen, their lungs not getting their medicine, so the lungs get in trouble. Yeah.
So like that question on the last test, so if you're smoking by oxygen tank, it's not going to catch on fire?
Oxygen will add to a fire. I take oxygen at night, okay? And oxygen adds to a fire. It's fuel. It's like gasoline. You throw gasoline on a fire, the oxygen, the fire will burn hotter, but gasoline is combustible, okay? Well, what oxygen does is it adds to a fire. It makes it burn hotter, it makes it burn faster. It's a fuel. And I can't remember the exact question, but that's what oxygen is, yeah?
And if someone's in the hospital and they're accustomed to like putting Vaseline on their lips, they won't let them use the Vaseline if they're on oxygen.
Yeah, because of the idea of the oil sparks. And then part of the other idea of that is if they've got lung problems, that Vaseline can vaporize and they can breathe it in. And that Vaseline can vaporize and actually get in their lungs and cause some type of a chemical irritant, chemical pneumonia. So now, your residents are probably going to be using two things for their oxygen. One here is the nasal cannula, in which it goes in their nose. I'm not going to do this because it's dirty, but it goes in their nose, and you can kind of see it has a little hook to it, because you don't want to put it in upside down, because then it'll jab them in the nose. So it has this little tab right here in the bottom. I don't know if you can see that. That has to be on the bottom. So literally, when you put the person's oxygen tubing on, you're going to put it on something like this, around the ears, and then right here, you have a little slider that if you need to, you can kind of tighten it up. But for the most part, a lot of times you simply don't need to do that, because it'll stay there just fine, you know? Now, the one thing that can happen a lot is this. The person takes it off and it drops on the floor. Okay? Now, look at the bottom of your shoes. That's what's all over the carpet. So, if there's something on the floor and they drop it and it's down there long enough, it gets on these cannulas, the person puts it back in their nose. It has a straight shot at their lungs. And if that happens enough, the accumulative effect could be very detrimental to them and could actually be the cause, and I personally think is one of the bigger causes for nosocomial infections. Because people drop these in the hospital, they drop them in the nursing home, and they just put them right back in. Now, a lot of your homes are basically going to say when you take them off, put them in a baggie. So they're kind of protected. But a lot of staff doesn't do it. The baggies disappear. Nobody's ordered baggies for a week, so we don't have any. So there again, if stuff's floating around everywhere in the hospital, even hanging it up like that, it don't even have to be on the floor, stuff is going to adhere to that, okay? So, there's a way, I hope coming out real soon, that basically will provide protection for that. And what it is basically something simple like this. It is just a little kind of a tube about this big that what basically happens is the person, it's right down here. So the person has the oxygen on, you know, it's around their ear, and it's right down here, just sitting there, not bothering nobody. And when they take off the oxygen, they can just slide it up and just like end up like that picture right there. Slide it in, and then of course then, if it drops on the floor, the prongs are basically protected. Nothing's going to get on it, nothing's going to get in there. Then when they want to put the oxygen back on, they can basically slide it out of the way. And the whole idea is that the prongs have virtually